Suratul Quran, Juz 16. Inshallah, today we'll continue from Suratul Kahf, ayah number 75. We'll see Suratul Maryam and Suratul Taha till ayah number 135. So here, as I mentioned before, we are doing summary of the whole Juz. We are not going ayah by ayah. Inshallah, let's start. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Ayah number 75. قَالَ أَلَمْ أَقُلْ لَكَ إِنَّكَ لَنْ تَسْتَطِيَ مَعِيَ صَبْرًا. And Khizr al-Islam said, did I not tell you that you would never be able to have patience? You know, he was keep on saying again and again to Musa al-Islam to have patience. He said, okay, I did mistake. قَالَ إِن سَأَلْتُكَ عَنْ شَيْءٍ بَعْدَهَا فَلَا تُسَاحِبْنِي. Musa al-Islam said, if I should ask you about anything after this, then do not keep me as a companion. You have obtained me, please give me an excuse. So meaning then you can send me away. If I ask you one more time, then you can, you know, take the action. That's what he means. There's a hadith regarding that. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, may Allah have mercy on Musa al-Islam. Had he been patient, he could have learned more. So this is how, like, till that time we know. And what happened, Fantalaka, so they set out until when they came to the people of a town. They asked for the food, but they refused to offer them any hospitality. Because in olden days, there was no hotels or motels, anything, or any restaurants. People used to do the hospitality, and they found there a wall about to collapse. So Khizr al-Islam restored it, and, you know, Musa al-Islam also helped it. So here, after that, now again, Musa al-Islam not able to do the sabr, he asked, if you wished, you could have taken for a payment. Now he is making a suggestion that over here, he's not really asking a question, but it's there implied as a question, you know. Why would you do a favor to the people who did not even offer food to you? And by the way, you did a service to them, so you could definitely charge them for it. You know, that's what he was saying. So Khizr al-Islam said, this is a parting between me and you. I will inform you of interpretation of that about which you could not have patience. So, you know, finally he said, now let's have the, you know, I'm going to partition with you right now, and I'm going to tell you the interpretation of whatever happened. So now we see over here the action of Khizr al-Islam. They kept, like, you know, Musa al-Islam not only interested, alert, but also very curious that this is the key to learning, you know. Then when the students is curious, then what happens? They eager to learn. So over here, whatever Khizr al-Islam did, and the fact that he told him no questions allowed, it kept Musa al-Islam alert, more interested, more curious. And whatever Khizr al-Islam did in the journey, we see that apparently it didn't make much sense. Killing a boy, building a wall of the people, he refused to offer any hospitality, and making a hole in the shape, means all this seems illogical, right? However, we learn the following verses. There was much hidden benefits in them, and there were many things in the life that. So here, he keep on, you know, not doing sabr, and finally, they are departed. And for example, a person could be sick. They might feel like, why this is happening to them? But in the big picture, they realize the sickness was indeed better for them, isn't it? So here, whatever happens, we have to say, Raditu Billahi Rabbo. So as for the ship, it belongs to a poor people working at sea. So intended to cause defect in it, so that after them, a king was there who was seizing all the good ship. So he want to save that ship. In order to save that ship, he just made the hole. He damaged the ship so that it will be saved. And as for the boy, his parents were believers, and we fear that he would overburden them by transgression and disbelief. So he was killed. So we intended that their Lord should substitute for them one better than him in the purity and nearer to mercy. Means they're going to have a Saleh child later on. So here, Abi bin Ka'ab reported, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the boy whom Al-Khizr had killed would grow up to be a disbeliever. And had he lived, he would have moved his parents to rebellion and unbelief also. So this is the thing. And here, later on, as far as the wall, it belonged to two orphan boys in the cities. In the city, there was a beneath it is a treasure for them, a hidden treasure. And their father had been very righteous person, you know. So your Lord intended that they reach maturity and extract their treasure. So that's how they made the wall, so that it will be, that treasure will be saved in that. This is the interpretation of that about which you could not have patience. That's what Nizar al-Islam said. And now the topic changes, you know, back and forth. This is wahi is going on and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam is informed. But you know, meanwhile, even Sahaba, companions, they will be asking question back and forth. Yasalunaka anil zilqarnain, and they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about zilqarnain. So I recite to you about him a report. Indeed, we established him upon the earth and we gave him everything away. So now, until when he reached, now he's talking about Zulqarnain, sitting in a spring dock, mud he found near it. Like, you know, a place which is very isolated and there was a mud and different kind of people. We said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, O Zulqarnain, either you punish them or else adopt among them a way of goodness. He said, as for the one who are wrongs, we will punish him. Then they will be returned to his Lord and he will punish him with a terrible punishment. But later on they were troubling and they asked the help of Zulqarnain. You know, they said, Zulqarnain, indeed Yajuj and Majuj are great corruptors in the land. So maybe assign for you expenditure that you might make between us and them a barrier. So Zulqarnain was a very intelligent person. What he did, that in which my Lord has established me, it's better what you offer. And then bring me the sheets of iron. Who is saying? Zulqarnain is saying, bring the sheets of iron until we had leveled them between the two mountain walls. He said, blow with the billows. And you know, then he made with the fire and bring me a pour over it molten copper. It means that they made the wall very strong. Okay. And Yajuj, Majuj were unable to pass over it. And they are unable to do any penetration. So Zulqarnain said, "Haza rahmatum min Rabbi." This is the mercy from my Lord. And when a promise of my Lord will come, he will make it level. On the day of judgment, it will be open again. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Yajuj and Majuj make a hole in the wall daily. When the hole become deep enough, so they can see the rays of the sun." Meaning, you know, on the day of judgment, it will, you know, able to collapse. So here we learn that, you know, till that time it will be as it is, it won't break. And here ayah number 99, وَتَرَكْنَا بَعْضُهُمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ يَمُوجُ فِي بَعْضٍ, and we will leave them the day surging over each other, means the day of judgment. And وَنُفِقَ فِي الصُّورِ فَجَمَعْنَاهُمْ جَمْعًا, and the horn will be blown, we will assemble them in assembly, everybody will be assembled. But here in ayah number 100 onwards, we have seen وَأَرَدْنَا جَهَنَّمْ يَوْمَئِذٍ لِلْكَافِرِينَ كَافِرِينَ عَرْضًا, and we will present hell the day to the disbelievers on display. And they can see those whose eyes had been with the cover removed from my remembrance, and they were not able to hear. But as for, later on it changes the topic, those who disbelieve in the verses of the Lord and their meeting him, their deeds have been worthless. And we will not assign to them on the day of resurrection any importance. In this regard, a hadith, on the day of resurrection, a huge man will come and he will have no weight, not even the weight of the wing of the mosquito. In the sight of the Allah, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam then recited this ayah, فَلَا نُقِيمُ لَهُمْ يَوْمَ قِيَامَةِ وَزْنَا. There is no wazan, you know, deeds, weight will be there. This is the recompense for them, is the hell. And then indeed you have believed and then righteous deeds. On ayah number 107, those who believe in righteous deeds, they will have garden and paradise and they will be there eternally. And here in the end of the surah, we see everything is informed to Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam through wahi, and he is only a prophet and he is informing us. And let's start Suratul Maryam. Suratul Maryam starts with Kaf, Ha, Ya, Ain, Swad. This is Huruf-e-Muqattad. And then it mentioned about Zakariya alayhi salam. Zikru Rahmati Rabbika Abduhu Zakariya. This is a mention of a mercy of your Lord to his servant Zakariya. When he called to his Lord a private supplication, he is making dua, you know. And in ayah number 4, Zakariya Islam is saying, you know, my bones are become weak and I am feeble, and you know, my head is full of gray hair. So, but still I have full hope. Walam yakun biduaika rabbi shakiya. That I have never despaired. I have never thought that it's not possible. I never gave up. That's what Zakariya al-Islam said. And he made dua. Wa inni khiftul mawla min wara'i. And indeed I fear the success after me. And my wife has been barren, so give me from yourself an heir. So he's asking, he's making dua, you know, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the dua. Zakariya al-Islam was told, oh Zakariya, indeed we gave you good tidings of a boy whose name will be Yahya. We have not assigned to anyone before this name. Means nobody has given this name before. And he said, oh my Lord, how will I have a boy when my wife has been barren and I have reached extreme old age? And now he's asking. An angel said, thus it be, yours Lord says, it is easy for him, and I created before you, you were nothing. So Zakariya al-Islam said, my Lord, make a sign for me. So your sign is that you will not speak to the people for 3 nights and being sound, even though you can able to speak, but you won't be able to. And so he came out to his people from the prayer chamber and signaled them to exalt Allah, you know, in the morning and evening. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to make lot of tasbih. Subhanallah wa bihamdi wa Allahu Akbar kabira, doing lot of tasbih. And here we learn, you know, when he was given the something good news, then also we have to be thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he was never despaired. Look at him. And here in ayah number 23, and eventually the pains of childbirth drove her to the trunk of the palm tree. She said, oh, I wish I had died before this and was in oblivious forgotten. You know, this is Maryam al-Islam, because she conceived and nobody touched her, and she was like, you know, she don't know what to say, and now she is going through labor pain, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is giving the hukum to, you know, just like shake the trunk, you will have the, you know, dates, you can eat it. So he called her from below. The angel said, do not grieve, your Lord has provided beneath you a stream. Even water was there. And she shake the trunk and she can eat the fresh dates, you know, rutab. So eat and drink and be content. That's what she has to do, because already she was going through a stress, physical and also mental stress. So, and vow to the most merciful that so I will not speak today to any man. You know, she was thinking. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, man samata naja, whoever is silent, he is saved. Isn't it? Even there are many times, you know, better you should be silent than speaking. So that's the hikmah here. Now we have seen how Zakariya al-Islam was so thankful, and we learn so much from here. And here later on in ayah number 28, O sister of Harun, your father was not a man of evil, nor was your mother unchaste. Here when we are talking about Maryam al-Islam, you know, people started pointing and, you know, saying different things. They said, how can we speak to me who is in the cradle of a child? He said, indeed, I am a servant of Allah, and he has given me the scripture and made me a prophet. Who is saying? Isa al-Islam is saying. And he has made me blessed, where I has enjoyed upon me prayer and zakat as long as I remain in alive, and made me dutiful to my mother. That is Maryam al-Islam. And he has not made me a wretched or tyrant, and peace on me the day I was born and the day I will die and the day I am raised alive. And here later on we see in ayah number 40, Inna nahnu nurisul arda wa man alaiha wa ilayna yurja'un. And indeed is he who inherit the earth, and whoever is on it used, they will be returned. We all have to go back when we die. And here waskuru fil kitabi, and mention in the book the story of Ibrahim al-Islam. Who was Ibrahim al-Islam? Innahu siddiqan nabiyya. He was Allah's friend indeed, was a man of truth and a prophet. So here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it does not benefit siddiq that he should be an invoker of curses. Meaning siddiq does not invoke curse on others. He does not swear to others, but he is always truthful. Truthful leads to righteousness, and righteousness leads to paradise. And man keep on telling the truth until he become a truthful person. So be truthful. So mention, he said to his father, O my father, why do you worship that which does not hear, does not see, will not benefit you at all? He's asking his father, Azar, O my father, indeed has come to me of knowledge, and that which has not come to you, so follow me, I will guide you to an even path. Now he's saying to his father, and he's saying, do not worship Shaitan, indeed Shaitan has ever been to the most merciful disobedient. He keep on saying with loving, you know, oh my father, indeed I fear that there will touch you punishment from the most merciful. His father said, have you no desire for my gods, Ibrahim? If you do not stop, I will surely stone you, so avoid me a prolonged time. And you know, he said, Salaam alaikum, peace be upon you, I will ask forgiveness for you from my Lord. Indeed, he is very gracious to me. Now here, Ibrahim al-Islam said, I'm going to make dua for you. And later on, he make dua. And those who invoke other than Allah, I will invoke my Lord, I will call upon. Except that I will not be invocation to my Lord unhappy. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, call upon Allah while being certain of being answered. In another narration it says, none of you should say, O Allah, forgive me if you want. But you, O Allah, bestow your mercy on me if you wish, or Allah, provide me if you wish. Okay? And so when he had left them, because Ibrahim al-Islam could not stay there anymore, and those they worship other than Allah, we gave him Isaac and Yaqub, and each of them we made a prophets. And here we see, and we call him from the side of the mount at his right, and brought him near confined to him. وَقُرْبَانْهُ نَجِيَا. Allah brought Musa al-Islam close in order to converse with him. Like, can you imagine, like Musa al-Islam, you know, so close, he heard Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he heard Allah, that when he asked Allah, I want to see you, because imagine hearing Allah, what's the next wish, I want to see you. Qurbanahu najiya, Musa al-Islam was brought so close. Do we want the, like, you know, kind of closeness we want? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you know, the Qurban, when draws you near, salati, this means drawing close to you. You know, in the salah, when we are very close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when you pray, you are like, you know, conversing with your Allah. Like, you know, then look at your conversing with him, you know. So be firm, and you know, when you are doing salah, you have to concentrate. And mention in the book, Ismail, indeed he was a true to his promise, and he was a messenger and a prophet. And he used to enjoin on his people prayer and zakat, and to his Lord is a pleasing. And later on here we see ayah number 60, except those who repent, believe and do righteousness, for those will enter paradise and will not be wrong at all. And here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in ayah number 66, وَيَقُولُ الْإِنسَانَ إِذَا مَا مِتُّ. And the disbeliever says, when I have died and I am going to be brought forth alive, they have the, you know, misconception, and they are asking, do we get alive after that? And there is none of you except that he will come too. There is upon your Lord an inevitability decree. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on the day of judgment, the bridge will be set up sharp like the sword, you know, edge of the sword. So the angel will ask, O Allah, who will you make this cross? Who is that you will order should go on this bridge? Who can cross this bridge? Allah will say, whoever I wish for my servants, whoever I wish for my servants. Only Allah can wish. You know, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, on the day of judgment, people will made to cross the bridge and they will fall from both its sides into hellfire. How they fall? Like a moths, you know. How the moths fall in the fire, the same way. But Allah will save whom He wants to save. And here we see in ayah number 86, and will drive the criminals he hell in the thirst. None will have power intercession except he who had given from the most merciful. No one can intercede that day. Inna allazeena amanu wa amilus salihat. Indeed, those who have believed and done righteous deed, the most merciful will appoint for them an affection. And this is very easy for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how many have we destroyed before them of generation? Do you perceive of them anyone or hear from them a sound? And here, inshallah, we'll start Suratul Taha. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Taha, hurufa muqattad. Ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'ana litashqa. We have not sent down to you the Qur'an so that you be distressed. The Qur'an is not meant to put us in hardship. Rather, it's to make our lives easier. Temporarily, it seems difficult. It feels difficult for a person to sit and listen or read or understand. But it's very easy. So if the person reflects, first of all, there is ease with difficulty. Ultimately, there will be always a greater reward. And here, ma anzalna alayka al-Qur'an ani tashqa. The Qur'an is not being meant to be a burden. So don't take it as a burden. Take it happily. And only a reminder for those who fear Allah. And revelation from He who created the earth and the highest heavens. Allah is saying, you know, I created heaven, earth. And most merciful is where? Throne. On the throne He established. To Him belongs what is heaven and on the earth. And later on in ayah number 19, qala alqiyaha ya Musa. Allah said, throw down, O Musa. He threw it down because it was Allah's order. Thereupon it was snake moving swiftly. Allah said, seize it and fear not, grab it, have trust in Allah. We will turn it into the former condition. So it happened. And draw in your hand to your side, it will come out with the without disease, another sign. So he was shown the hand was white without any disease. Izhab ila Firauna innahu taga. Go to Pharaoh, indeed he was transgressed. And here there is a dua in ayah number 25 onwards. Qala rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wa hlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. O Allah, expand for me my chest with assurance and ease for me my task and untie the knot for my from my tongue, and they may understand my speech. So this dua we should also make dua. We should also make a habit to recite this dua. Waj'al li wazira min ahli, and appoint for me a minister from my family. And you know, he asked Harun al-Islam to make the wazir. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever among you is appointed to a position of authority, if Allah wills good for him, He will give him a righteous minister who will remind him if he forgets and help him if he remembers. And later on, and let him share my task, and that we may exalt you much and we may remember you much. And here, inna kunta bina basira. Indeed, you are of us ever seeing. Qala qad utiyata. Allah said, you have been granted your request, O Musa al-Islam. And we had already conferred you, favor upon you another time. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding, you know, when we inspired to your mother, we inspired, you know, and talking about how Musa al-Islam's mother cast into the chest, into the box. Meaning Musa al-Islam was put in the box into the river, and the river will throw it on the bank, and there will take him an enemy to me, and even though they were enemy, they took him and bestowed upon you love from me, and that you would be brought upon under my eyes. Means, you know, the enemy, they have love for the Musa al-Islam. That's what Musa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is reminding, and we favored you when your sister went and said, shall I direct you to someone who will be responsible for him? You know, sister was watching, even though it was put in the water, tawakkul ala Allah, and but they were tying the camel, and she was following, and mother said, go and find out where the child is going, and she and you killed someone, we have saved you from the retaliation and tried you with the severe trial, and you remain some years among the people of Madian. So here Musa al-Islam's sister was just watching, you know, and she was following it. And okay, go you and your brother with my signs and do not slacken in my remembrance. Here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Allah will continue to plant new people in this religion and use them in his obedience. Here we learn, like, you know, even though she was very much worried for the child, she has to put in the water. And then after that, the sister of Musa al-Islam was following, and later on we learn, like, you know, how they were worried, but still they have tawakkul ala Allah. Go both of you, Pharaoh, indeed he has transgressed, and speak to him with gentle speech. You know, here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking, giving the amar, hukum, to speak to Pharaoh gently. So we should speak gently to each other, perhaps he may be reminded. So here we Allah said, fear not, indeed I am with you both. Because Musa al-Islam, so like, he has fear in the chest, and Allah is saying, no, don't fear, you can go there. So who is the Lord of your two? Now Musa and Harun al-Islam, they went, and Pharaoh is saying, qala faman rabbukuma ya Musa, who is your Lord? Musa al-Islam said, our Lord is who gives each thing its form and then guided it. Pharaoh said, what is the cause? What is the case of the former generation? The knowledge thereof with my Lord is record. My Lord neither errors nor forgets. And later on he was keep on asking question, and he want to belittle and mock, but Musa al-Islam was answered very sensibly. They said, indeed these are two magicians, have Musa and Harun. And then they said, okay, let's gather some people and like, you know, you can come and let's have this. And then, you know, they gather all the people, and later on when they came, so the magicians, you know, they also started putting the things and showing all sorts of things. And when Musa al-Islam threw his staff, everything was eaten by the like gigantic snake, and everybody, like in ayah number 70, we see all the people fell in the prostration. And you believe him before I gave you permission? So here he's saying, how come you are before giving permission, and you know, you are believing it? Because he thinks he is God, Pharaoh. And but still they said, they have firm belief, and they said, no, we gonna believe no matter what, one day we have to die, so we believe in the Rabb of Musa and Harun. And Bani, O children of Israel, we delivered you from your enemy, and we made an appointment with you at right side of the mount, and we sent down to you man and quails. You know, now reminding of all the you know, fadl of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Seeing it from the good things with which we have provided you, and do not transgress. My anger should descend upon you, and he upon whom my anger descend has certainly fallen. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the human being does not feel any container that is worse than his stomach. So here we learn later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was made you hasten from your people of Musa. And he said, they are close upon my tracks, and I hasten to you, my Lord, and you be pleased. And later here in ayah number 98, your God is only Allah, except for whom there is no deity. He has encompassed all the things in knowledge. And they will murmur among themselves, you remind not 10 days in the well. You know, here life in the world will seem so short, like, you know, they feel like, okay, day or so, or only few days they spend. but it's like, you know, because they are deluded in this world. And here in ayah number 110, Allah know what is presently before them and what will be after them, but they have failed who careers in injustice. And here in ayah number 121, and Adam and his wife ate of it, and so the private parts became apparent because of eating that fruit, because shaitan whispered and they were deluded and then carried away, and because of that their satr was open. And after that, after doing the mistake, they ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness. And you know, incident of Adam and Hawa is repeated more than 7 times. And here in ayah number 128, then has it not become clear to them how many generations we destroyed before them, and they walk among their dwellings? Indeed, in that are signs for those who are intelligent. And here it's you know, in ayah number 130, so fasbir ala ma yaquluna, so be patient of what they say. Sabbi bihamdi rabbika, and exalt Allah with praise of your Lord. When qabla tulu'i shamsa, before the rising of the sun and before its setting, and during the periods of the night, exalt him. Wa min anai layli fasabbihi wa tarfa nahar, and at the end of the days, la'allaka tarda, so that you may be satisfied. So here there is a hadith regarding that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that he who observes prayer before rising of the sun and his setting, which two prayers are these, Fajr and Asr, and then he would not enter hellfire. And here later on in the end, we see ayah number 135 saying, each of us is waiting, so wait, for you will know who are the companions of the sound path and who is guided. So fasta'lamuna man ashabus sirati sawiya man ihtada. So what do we learn here? That a person must continue to work, to strive in the way of Allah, and it is Allah's decision to reveal the truth whatever, like whenever he please. There is a time when a person does not want to accept truth, but when a time comes when truth is established, such that is the, you know, you can't deny, don't reject that time, fear Allah and accept the truth. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is being advised over here that even though people reject, you remain firm, you keep conveying what is the lesson for us, that we have certainty, we are doing for the sake of Allah, just convey the message. We can't convince people because Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been ordered. So we are the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka.